Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. Thanks for joining me for a chalkboard chat. This is where we dive right into the meat of it for those who want to get straight to it. This is the golden ratio. I'm going to show a few on the eye. Remember, Da Vinci has an amazing museum in Venice in Italy. I spent 2 days there just going through it. You could spend much more. He was obsessed with it and used it in his art. Beauty, we know, a component of it is angles, it's contours. That's what we're doing now in aesthetic clinics. Let's dive in to a chalkboard chat all about the eye. Remember, subscribe, like, and share these videos with your friends. So this picture here is from a video I did talking about how we know the edge of the brow. You can go back and watch that video where we draw a line from the nasal ala through the lateral canthus of the eye, which is here. That gives us the tail of the brow. But I wanted to come back to this picture and show you a couple golden ratios of the eye. Incidentally, the interpupillary distance on average is about 62 millimeters. An easy way to think of that is it is an eye width apart. And as is the nose is generally an eye width apart. But if we're looking at golden ratios, one would be looking at the width of the eye itself and then to the center of the nose. And I'll come back, let's draw that a little bit straighter. If through the eye itself, from the medial canthus, which is here, the lateral canthus, which is here, and then drawing a line right down through the center, this would represent 1, and this is 1.61. And Leonardo da Vinci, of course, was obsessed with this number. I'll do a complete video on what that number and what phi means. It's a mathematical number used in art, but some people were obsessed with it. It was in paintings, and they found it in a lot of the Greek and Roman architecture as well. But as it applies to beauty, that is one. Let's do a second one here. If we look again at the center of the face to the lateral canthus of the eye to the edge of the face, that would represent 1.61 to 1. And that golden ratio is important because when we're doing cheek filler here, the lateral cheek represents beauty, youth, and fertility. And if you go too far out, the eyes appear too close set. And so it's important to know or have some semblance of how far out we can come here before we change how the eyes perceive, and coming out too wide gives the cat look, which of course people don't like, just like the duck look down here. Now, if we look at the eye itself, there's also a golden ratio within the eye. If we look from the inner canthus to the lateral limbus, sorry, let's draw that a little more straight. From the inner canthus, lateral limbus of the eye to the outside of the eye, we see again a number that approximates 1.61 to 1, if you believe in that ratio. And I'll do a complete video on that, but I wanted to do a quick video just to show you what phi, some people call it phi, represents. And the question is why, but certainly one thing we know, that beauty definitely has a math component, because when we look, we know that this face represents beauty. The question becomes why, and that's what we're here to look at. Certainly glow plays a role, certainly angles, the cat eye tilt, the brow, but also the mathematical features that we look at. The edge of the lip comes to the mid pupil or even the lateral pupil. And if we're going down and looking in the lip, the ratio of the upper to lower, which 1 to 1 is more accepted now really than 1.61 to 1.
So thanks for joining me for a chalkboard chat. Remember, like the video, subscribe, share it with someone who you think will benefit from the information, and most importantly, keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.